This particular video is sponsored by LastPass. Huge thanks to them for making it possible to visit a phone I might not have got to test otherwise. Switching phones can be a pain. That's one of the reasons I've stuck with my own Galaxy S8 Plus as a daily driver for so long now. One app that can make switching phones easier is LastPass. Already used by millions of people, LastPass has the ability to generate long, secure, and encrypted passwords that you don't have to remember yourself. It stores all of your passwords for you, so no need to write them down or use that same insecure password for everything. It's worth a shot if you spend any amount of time on the internet. Whether on your computer or your cell phone, the app itself is free. But if you want some extra perks like a gig of encrypted storage, it's only $2 a month. I'll leave a link for you down in the video description. Huge thanks to LastPass for sponsoring this video. Now, let's jump into the durability test. Let's get started. It's time to test the Xiaomi Note 5 Pro. Xiaomi has not always done well on my channel in the past. The Mi 5 had a pretty rough day during my durability test. Let's hope this Note 5 Pro, released this year, fares better, because this blue is beautiful. Seriously though, this blue is one of the coolest colors that I've seen on a smartphone in a while. It would be a shame if someone accidentally scratched it. Let's start with the screen. My systematic durability test always include my Mohs picks to see what the screen is made from. Plastic would scratch at level 3, which we've seen on some other budget phones. This Xiaomi Note 5 with its oddly measured 5.99-inch screen has advertised Gorilla Glass, so we should start seeing scratches at a level 6 with deeper grooves at a level 7. Pretty standard so far, especially for 2018. Normal keys, coins, and razor blades won't scratch the front glass. Xiaomi is advertising a 20-megapixel selfie camera on this thing, with, something unique, a front-facing flash. The far circle on the right is actually an LED, which is nifty. The earpiece is made from a hard metal mesh and is very securely adhered to the phone. Not bad so far for a budget phone. The volume rocker is made from metal, along with the super small power button. The bottom section of the phone, however, is made from plastic. And even though it does include our favorite headphone jack, it's located next to a very much outdated micro USB slot. This phone was released in 2018, where it's beyond time to move on to USB-C ports. While the bottom might be plastic, the sides are definitely made from metal, along with the SD card tray, which can conveniently hold two SIM cards, or a SIM and SD card combo. The only thing that would make me more impressed is if this phone could change the channels on my TV. But wait, it can't. Built into this budget phone from Xiaomi is an IR blaster that allows you to control speakers, TVs, projectors, and DVD players, all with that little black remote control LED on the top. Androids can do some pretty cool things. This budget Note 5 Pro does have dual cameras on the back, but no telephoto or wide-angle lens, which basically means that the second camera is more of a glorified decoration than anything else. The plastic flash is separate from the protective glass over the cameras, probably to keep the reflections of the flash to a minimum. The slightly recessed fingerprint scanner is scratchable. My razor blade does its normal damage. It's interesting to note that a lot of fingerprint scanners can survive this exact same abuse and still function like normal. But this time around, with the Xiaomi Note 5 Pro, it won't acknowledge my finger and keeps saying that the sensor is dirty. So the fingerprint scanner does fail this time around. Of course, this is a bit more abuse than a well-cared-for phone would normally sustain during a 2 or 3 year lifespan. But that's the point of this video. My phone gets tested so you don't have to find out the hard way with your own phone. Plus, I draw one fantastic looking bluebird. The end caps of this phone might be plastic, but the center section is definitely metal. This 5.99-inch screen is an IPS LCD display, so we should see the pixels go black and turn off, but hopefully recover and switch back on again. The Note 5 Pro lasted about 9 seconds before recovering completely. Let's see if this Note 5 Pro is structurally durable, or if Tweety gets his head popped off. The first bend had me nervous for our buddy Tweety. There is a very visible and very permanent kink in between the power and volume buttons. Bending from the opposite direction yields a lockout, but no catastrophic damage. There are permanent gaps between the frame and the glass, and the screen is unclasped along the middle, but everything is still alive and functioning. This beautifully colored Lake Blue Note 5 Pro, with its pretty darn durable bird on the back, has survived my durability test. Pretty impressive, and it gets a thumbs up from me. If you enjoy bluebirds, come hang out with me on Twitter, hit that subscribe button. Thanks a ton for watching, and I'll see you around.